Hello everyone and welcome back to the Keep Productive YouTube channel. On today's feature, I'm going to be passing over to Louise from Solopreneur Sidekick, and she will be doing a feature today about how she plans and organizes her goals inside of Trello. This will be an exciting feature if you're a Trello user. There are definitely some gems that you will learn from this feature, so feel free to use the timestamps below, learn all about how Louise uses her Trello. Now, Louise runs a fantastic channel here on YouTube, and I will include it below. It is fantastic because if you're in the marketing field or you're actually learning all about being and running your own business, it's definitely a fantastic resource for that. And I found her initially through some Squarespace features. She actually helped me with fixing some things in my Squarespace account. So a big thank you to her. It is fantastic to have her on, and I was very excited to bring her talking all about Trello today. So without further ado, thank you very much to Louise. I will be on her channel soon, so do make sure to subscribe and do comment below with any questions you have for her. So guys, without further ado, thank you very much, and we'll dive into this feature.
Hey Francesco, thank you so much for having me on the Keep Productive YouTube channel today. I'm super excited to be here. For everyone watching, if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, make sure that you do because it is full of so many amazing tips. My name's Louise, and I also have a YouTube channel. It's called Solopreneur Sidekick, and I talk all about entrepreneurship and make the tech in online business as easy as possible. So if you are an entrepreneur or dreaming about starting your own business, definitely come and hang out with me over there, but after you've subscribed to this channel. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you how I hit my business goals using Trello. Trello is an amazing free project management tool that you can use to keep your entire business organized. So I'm going to be sharing with you three of my top boards that I use and that you can implement in your own business. Board number one is all about tracking your goals. I think it's super important that we track our goals on a daily basis so that we know where we're at and what needs to be improved. So, for example, one of the biggest goals in business we need to track is our sales. So I have a board specific for that. And then what I do is I come over here and add a list. So I'm going to click on that and then type in big goals. And I use cards to list out all of my sales goals. So for example, I would love to get 1,000 sales this year. And what's great about this is now every time you come and take a look at this board, you're reminded of your big goals. Next, what I do is I separate out my list by the month. So I type in April sales, May sales, and so on. You get the idea. So now every time that a sale comes in, I add a card, I type in the date that the sale came in, the name of the person who purchased, and any other helpful sales data that I have. So for example, I use email marketing to generate sales, and I love to know what email prompted people to buy. So I'll type in something like this. And I have two different ways that I drive sales. One is through a free trial and one is through a webinar. So I actually use labels for this. If you click on the little pencil icon and then edit labels, you can set up labels for your own business. So then I can just simply color code all of my sales and really get a quick glance at what drove those sales. So I find this a really nice and easy way to track my sales goals as well as gather important information along the way. And when the month is complete, I simply come up here and write down how many sales I got for that month. Board number two is all about your content. I use this for my YouTube channel, but you could use this for your blog, your podcast, whatever type of content you're creating for your business. As you know, there are a lot of steps involved, so I use this board to keep my team on track, make sure that we don't forget anything, and that we're keeping on schedule. So this is our content marketing board, which is visible to all members on our team. The most important part I want to draw your attention to is this video template card. So I'm going to click on that, and as you can see, each member of our team has their tasks for each video laid out in a checklist. So for example, we have my tasks, which are to write the script and film the video, Anno, who does all of our graphic design, Nathan, who does our editing, uploading, and blog post formatting, and Kyla, who schedules all our pins to Pinterest. So you can easily add something like this for yourself. Just scroll up to the top, click on checklist, title your checklist, click add, and then you can add your items down here. So then what you want to do is X out of here, and you want to keep this under an important links list. Okay, so this stays here at all times. Then when it's time to create a video, you're going to click on this little pencil symbol, click copy, type in the title of an upcoming video that you're creating. So I'm going to do how to upload YouTube videos to IGTV. Okay. And then I'm going to change the list to videos in progress. Create card. Okay, awesome. So as you can see, we now have a card for this specific video that has all of the tasks already laid out on this card. So then we do a few more things. I come in here and I add a due date. So this one is going to come out on April 1st, for example. Okay, great. And with Trello, you can actually add a power-up so that you can view the calendar view. And if I click on that, I can see the calendar view of our video schedule. We like to work a month in advance, so when you normally come in, you'll see all the videos for the month already laid out. So working with this specific video, a team member will come in here, click on this, and as they complete their tasks, they can come in and check these off. Okay, and then what we like to do is also add labels, because if we were to just leave it like that, you would just see 4 out of 20 completed. So we've actually added labels for each person as well. So you're going to click that little pencil icon, then edit labels. And as you can see, we all have an individual label for when we are done our tasks. So in this example, Anna has completed all of her tasks, so she would also come and add in this label, and then that way I know that she has done her part for that video. So when all items are done, it's going to look like this, and then we know that it has been posted and it gets moved to this column over here. Board number 3 is all about the follow-up. I don't know about you, but I used to be terrible at following up with pitches that I sent out. But since implementing this board, I've had a much higher success rate, so hopefully this helps you in your business as well. So this is my follow-up board. The way that I format this one is I first create a list for people that I want to pitch. So I'm going to click add a list, title this to pitch. And then I write down the names of cool channels that I want to work with, other collaborations. I add them all as an individual card. So for example, let's say I wanted to collab with Keep Productive. I would put their name in here. And then I can click on the card and add more details in the description area here. So I would add in more details as well as their email. So then it's time for me to actually send out the email. So I have another list called Waiting on Response, another list called Followed Up, and finally Booked. So once I've actually sent that email to Keep Productive, I move their card over to the Waiting on Response tab. And what I really like about this is I can come in here and it will tell you on what date you moved the card over. So you know what date you sent out the email. So if it's been a while and you haven't heard back from them, you can send them a follow-up email. Once you've done that, you're going to move them to the followed up tab. So as I said, this already has given me way better results, and it's very likely that you will be moving that card into the booked tab. So those are the 3 most important Trello boards that allow me to hit my business goals. I hope that you found this video helpful and that these boards help you hit your business goals as well. Thanks again to Francesco and team for having me on the channel today. This was so much fun and I hope to be back soon. And if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, make sure that you do for tons more awesome tips on how to be more productive.